Ladies and gentlemen, hello. This is a communication of the Exomechanic Laboratory, about the MTG. You can see here a prototype. Until now you understood four main energy sources. Chemicals, with plenty sort of batteries. Thermicals, like oil, gas, and coal. Renewables energies, as solar, wind and hydraulic. Nuclear energy. And from now on, you can add the exomechanical energy. This kind of energy has the advantage to compensate the flaws of every other sources said previously, as to reduce pollution or costs, manufacture, use and maintain costs. With the MTG, you'll have access to portable generators for supplying your computer, your batteries, your main work tools. This is very convenient if you are in move, camping, or in isolated places like scientific bases. The MTG replaces the engine of your car or truck, making you free about autonomy and fueling. It so allows you to supply your house in electricity, because a house always need less power than a car. It adapts as well to boats, propeller planes, helicopters, also to trains. And moreover, a MTG power plant produces as much usable energy as a nuclear power plant, without the inconvenience of the radioactive wastes. Of course, exomechanical energy is not flawless. About the MTG, let mention the use of rare earth magnets. A raw oscillating output power, which mean in staccato, an effect that can be seen in stepper motors. It has a slow reactivity and an excessive consumption will abruptly stop the machine, then it needs much time to restart. As every engine, MTG has limitations. Apart this, all materials used during the construction process are recyclable. The MTG doesn't emit any particle by itself, of course it depends of the use you would make. So, how does it run? Let me firstly introduce a formulae, and this will be the only one. P equal T times omega. Power is the multiplication of torque by speed. In electrical engineering, there is two main systems, the motor and the alternator. They are called rotary machines. And these machines are made with the same main elements, the stator, and the rotor. Into a motor, and particularly those we can find actually. The rotor is constituted by coils in copper wire and the stator by permanent magnets. When an electric current is applied, a magnetic field is produced that turn the rotor. On the opposite, turning the rotor induce a current into the wires. The machine is said reversible. For the alternator, things are somewhat different. The constitution is relatively the same, but the system is made irreversible. Turning the rotor induces the electric current as well. But applying a current doesn't make the rotor to turn anymore. The interlude on these two machines is important because it allows to introduce the notion of an irreversible motor, in other words, a magnetic torque generator, a MTG. So this is how this technology works. The MTG torque is generated by a magnetic monopole in the stator level. The field is then modulated by an external controller designed in paramagnetic materials. And the usable mechanic power lead the output axis. The fundamental principles stay those of electrotechnical rotary machines. However, because the torque depends only to the stator's magnetism, itself isolated from the pilotage system, the power available in output is much higher than the consumed power. And all of this, is normal. It's the strict application of the formulae. P equal T times omega. Power is the multiplication of torque by speed. If you want something more concrete, we keep some models and the research's prototype is at your disposal. It remains necessary magnets to be included so you can do every test you will. Why didn't we keep the prototype's magnets? Reason is simple. Large magnets are hazardous to handle. Practically, the prototype would have been impossible to carry, neither in train or plane. But we would always being able to demonstrate the claims. Ladies and gentlemen, the MTG technology is at your disposal. Time came to you to decide what doing next. Will you leave the oil engines? Will you leave the nuclear power plants? Will you join us to build the 21st century? Here is the end of this video. We hope you liked it. Don't hesitate to comment, share, and moreover talk about it. It was the Exomechanic Laboratory, March 2015.